Hello friends, so in today's video we are going to see concise physics chapter work energy and power, right? So we'll start with a work first. So if I ask you what is work, is going to be very easy answer, because whatever you are doing in your daily life, those all are thing to be considered as a work. For example, if you are going to buy some vegetables, that is a work. If you are even reading, if you are even studying, those are also considered to be as a work. Even if you are cooking food, that is also a work. But in physics, if somebody asks you what is work, that is a different definition. Because in physics, work is said to be done when, in case, two things happen. Number one, let's say this is a body A. Okay, so this is a body A moving from position S1 to S2, right? And some force is been applied to this body, let's say force F. So we can say work done only when a body moves under the influence of any force. So we can see here, by applying certain force, this body is moved. So we can say work is done. For example, if you are applying a force, let's say this location is S1, and there will be no displacement. So in this case, there is a no displacement of body, no displacement of the body. Hence, we can say work done is zero. Okay. So work done only happens when once we are applying certain force, then body moves from one location to another. If we are applying force and body is not moving, that is a no displacement, then in that case we can say work is not done. Let me write this in a definition. So work is said to be done only when the force applied on a body makes the body move. Okay, so this is a definition, and that means what? That means there is a displacement. There is a displacement of the body. So now you understood what is work in physics. So let's say there are some examples as well. For example, a man is pushing in a car. You can see in this figure, a man is pushing a car. It's mentioned in figure 2.1. So that is one of the example, and car is moving. There is a motion in this car. Second example will be a cyclist while pedaling a cycle, or a horse while pulling a cart. Even the boy is going upstairs, or a coolie lifted a load. All are applying certain force which produce some motion, that is, there is a displacement. That's why we can say work is done. That's why we can say they do work, right? However, if a man tries to push a wall, if you can see in this figure, if a man try to push a wall, or a child try to push a heavy stone and they are unable to move it, that means there is a no displacement. then scientifically no work is being done by them, right? So these are certain example which shows the meaning of a work. Now tell me one thing, if a coolie does no work while standing with a heavy load on his head, is that a work done or no? You guess rightly. Since there is a no displacement, then there will be a no work done. So that is the basic understanding with some example about what is work. Let's see our next topic, which is measurement of work. So we have as of now understood what is work, when we are saying then certain work is done, and when we are saying work is not done. Now next topic is measurement of work. So as of now we have understood what is work, when we are saying certain work is done, and in what case we can say work is not done, right? So how do we measure the work? So second heading is measurement of work. Measurement of work. So the amount of a work done by a body, let's say this is a body, okay, so how much amount this body work, this depends on two things. Number one, the magnitude of force. The magnitude of the force applied, that is one, means how much force is being applied on this body, let's say A. That's one. Second thing is, which is also one of the very critical thing while measuring the work, is the displacement. The displacement produced by the force applied on this body. By the force. For example, if you applied a force F here and its body moved, then that displacement we are talking about here. Right? So we need to understand that we can measure any work by using two things. Number one, we need to find out the magnitude. And also we need to find out the displacement provided by that force, right? To understand this, let's see two example. In example number one, let's say we have a body A and B. This is body A and this is body B. This body moves from this to this distance by applying force F1, and this body also moves to the same distance by applying force F2. Now if I say the force 1, that is F1, is greater than F2, what does it mean? That means we applied more force on this body, and then we are able to move this body from, let's say, distance S1 to S2. That means this body is weighted, let's say this is 10 kg, but by applying a small force this body move from same distance S1 to S2. That means this body is light weighted, let's say 1 kg. Here we can say the impact of force. By applying more force, we can move the distance from S1 to S2, and that is same, that here S1 and S2 are same, right? So this is example of where we are considering the magnitude of force. We are here by applying a small force, but here we are applying the more force. Similarly, in another case, this is example number 2 of this measurement of work. Now here we have two body. This is, let's say again, body number A and this is body number B. Okay, and now this distance, once we are applying certain force, is greater. Let's say this is S1 and this is S2, where S2 is greater than S1, right? And here force applied on both the bodies are same, that is F. So what we can understand using this, that both bodies by applying a similar force moved at different distance. Displacement varies. This is displacement. So that could be case that if we are applying a force F, but this body is of 10 kg, but on the same, if we are applying this, let's say this is of 5 kg. So by say applying same force, we are able to move up to, let's say, S1 distance, but on the same force, this body moves to S2, which is greater. So on this basis, we can say the amount of work, let me just write this, the amount of work done by a force is equal to the product of the force and the displacement. Of the point of application of the force in the direction of force. What does it mean? I will explain you. So this is the definition, this is the conclusion we have made based on this example, based on this understanding, right? So the amount of work done, we are calculating the amount of work done by what basis? By the basis of product of the force and the displacement. Means work done by a force is equal to the product of, means work done is equal to product of what? Force into what? The displacement. By applying a force, what is the displacement? So if we multiply this force and displacement of the point of application, like we are applying the force here, and the last line is saying point of application of the force in the direction of force. So displacement happen on which direction? On the same direction of force, right? We are applying a force in this direction, and displacement also moving on the same direction, right? So in that case, work done is equal to force into displacement. I am writing again, displacement of the point of application of force in the direction of force, right? In the direction of force. Now if we can see this figure, so there is a body, let's say this is a body, and this body moves from this location to this location, right? So this is, let's say, A position, and then let's say this position is B. So distance is S from here to here, right? And the force is applied on this body, let's say F, right? So this is figure in your book is given 2.3. So we need to calculate the work done by a force. So this is example of work done by a force, right? So in this figure, if you can say, suppose F is a constant, what means we are applying whatever force, that is not going to be changed. Let's say if we are applying 2 Newton of force, that force is going to be constant, right? And using that force, the body displaces from position number A, this is position number A, to position number B, right? Along its own direction, that means on the direction of force. Then the displacement of a body A, B, which is S, and the work done is, we can say, work done is equal to what? Force, this one, and as we say, the product of force and displacement. Displacement here is what? S. So we can say work done is equal to force into displacement. And here we assume that force does not change during the displacement. Means if we are applying a 2 Newton of force, then this force is constant, is not going to be changed. And if there is a no displacement, no displacement means what? S is zero. Z-E-R-O. Then in that case, what happened? Work done is equal to force into zero. That means work done is equal to zero. Thus, we can say if a force act on a body and the body does not move, right? If you are applying certain force and body is not moving, that means what? That means there is no displacement. That means displacement is zero. Then no work done is done, or no work is done. Right? So this is another definition we derived based on our example. And always remember, work is a scalar quantity. Means what? It has no direction. So friends, so far we have seen, then we have applying certain force and body is moving in the same direction. I have explained that also here, right? We are applying a force in this direction and body is displaying in the same direction. But it is not necessary that a force always cause the displacement of a body in its own direction, right? I am going to explain this by using two examples. Let me explain you this, that if under any circumstances, if force displaces a body in a direction other than the direction of force, then we can determine the amount of work done by a force in two ways, right? So here I am taking two examples where we are applying certain force, and but the direction of that body is moving in different direction. So first is by finding the component of displacement along the force. So So here we are calculating the things by displacement. We are finding the component. How we are going to do this, I will explain you. And second thing what we are going to see here is by finding the component of force in the direction of displacement. Right. So basically, in two circumstances, in two cases, we are going to see that it is not necessary that the force always cause the displacement of body in its own direction. Right. So let's try to understand the first condition, which is by finding the component of displacement along the force. Right, let me draw a quick figure for you first. Suppose there is an inclination, and in that inclination some body is there, right? And you are applying a force F in this body. This is a body, and that body of course supposed to move in this direction, right? But the inclination is having certain angle, certain degree, that's why it's moving upward, and this body move till here, right? This point is C. That means this should be like we are applying certain force here and its body moving again. The force is constant here, right? And this distance, this is A, and this displacement is what? This is S. Now if we draw a perpendicular distance from this location where we are applying the force to the body where force direction is supposed to be there, this will be, let's say my point is B. So in this figure we can say, suppose a constant force F, this is F, act on a body along A to B. So force is applying on this body and is supposed to move into this direction, this one, right? But it displaces the body on an inclined surface A to C, but the body is moving from this to this direction. And the displacement of the body is AC, which is A and C, and that displacement we are saying this is S. Now, which is the at angle theta to the direction of force, right? Now, to find the component of displacement in this direction of force, that is along AB, that is we need to find out here. You understood the problem? So the problem statement is we need to find out the component of displacement in the direction of force, which is A and B. So to solve this, we draw a perpendicular distance CB, then the component of displacement in the direction of AB we need to calculate, and we can say work done is what? Force into displacement. Here force is what? F, right? And displacement is what? AB, ideally, right? But in this triangle ABC, we can say this right angle triangle ABC, we have a formula, cos theta is equal to what? Base oblique hypotenuse, right? So in this triangle, what is base? Base is AB, oblique hypotenuse what? AC. Therefore, this we can also write AB oblique S, because this is my S distance, this is my displacement, and this is what? This is my cos theta. So we can further solve this, and we can say AB is equal to S cos theta. And if we put this value in our equation number 1, let's say this is my equation number 1, which is my work is equal to force into displacement, then work is equal to force into S cos theta. What does it mean? This means work is equal to force into component of displacement in the direction of force. Okay, so this is the equation which we derived in case of certain inclination, and that too in the direction of force. If there is any inclination where body is moving in another direction which is different than the direction of force, right? So that is the condition number 1. Let's see condition number 2, where by finding the component of force along the displacement, okay. So let me draw the same diagram again. There is an inclination and certain force is applied on a body. This is a body, and body moves from here to here. And this is the force, and this is, let's say, B, this is C, this is A, and degree is, let's say, theta, and this displacement is again S, right? Now in this case we are calculating the force along the displacement. Means what? Body displaced from this location to this location, right? So we are calculating the component on the same direction, means we are calculating on the inclination side of the force, right? That means earlier we are calculating force in this direction, but body is moving into another direction. In this case we are calculating the force in the same direction, means what? Means this one. This is my force, that is, which is applying on the same direction, right? So this theta we are going to calculate, and we need to also calculate the perpendicular distance here. Now let's try to understand this figure. This is the figure all about. Let me explain you the figure. If P and A, that means this and this, which is a vector because this is having a certain direction, represent the magnitude and direction of force acting on a body, then the component of force in the direction of displacement, that is A and C. So in this figure we can see that if PA, this is P and this is A, represent the magnitude and direction of force acting on a body, yes, this is the direction and magnitude that is applying on this body, then the component of force, that means this component of force in the direction of displacement, means in the direction of displacement, means we are talking about this force, okay, that is along AC. Yes, this is along AC is NA. That means this is N and this is A. Right, so component of force will be NA. Therefore, work done, if we are going to calculate, so work done is what? Force into displacement. Okay, here force is what? Force is from N to A. So we can say NA, and displacement from A to C. So that is AC. We can also write this NA into S, because S we can say this is displacement. So further, if we see cos theta is equal to what? Base upon hypotenuse, TNUS, right? Base is this one, which is NA, and hypotenuse is what? PA. So we can say PA cos theta is equal to NA, and PA is what? PA, if you can see this to this, is what? This is our force. So we can say F into cos theta is equal to NA, and in this equation number 1 we can say work is equal to NA is what? F cos theta into S, right? So this is our another derivative, where in case of force is along the displacement with some angle, work will be F cos theta into S, right? So let me just write this. So this will be work is equal to component of force in the direction of displacement. Okay, into displacement. So that is another definition. Now, what we can derive, or what we understood based on, let's say this is my equation number 1 and this equation number 2, right? I am just marking star. 1 star equation and 2 star equation. What we can derive, or what we understood, right? So it is clear from these two equations, where W is equal to, that is work is equal to force into S cos theta, and work is equal to F cos theta into displacement, is that first number, magnitude of force F second part is magnitude of displacement, which is S, and third part is where cosine of the angle theta between the direction of force and displacement S, that is cos theta. Okay, so we have understood these two conditions, that finding the component of displacement along the force and finding the component of force along the displacement. So there is one more important note here. See, the force and displacement F and S, both are having a vector quantity means they have certain direction. Whereas work W is scalar quantity. So work is expressed as what? F, that is vector, dot S, right? So the dot product of two vectors is a scalar. That's how work is considered as an F scalar, though force and displacement is a vector quantity. Next topic is about some special case in this, right? So special case is what? I will explain you. Let me write some special cases. So in this book, basically three cases are there, right? In first case, is saying, this is case number one, where is saying, if the displacement is in the direction of force, right? So displacement is in the same direction of force, means if you see this graph, displacement is in different direction, force is in this direction but displacement is going in another direction, that means there is some theta degree of difference. But if direction is same, right, then theta degree is what? Zero, right? So this is the case what we are explaining here. So let me just draw this quickly first to explain you. Suppose this is the direction of force, this is the body, this is body after move, this is the force. So this is what we have understood earlier, right? So where body is moving from A to B, but that is different direction, right? But in this case is saying the direction will be same, means what? The body is moving in the same direction like this, means if we apply force, the theta will be 0 degree, right? That means what? That means cos theta is equal to 0 and cos theta 0 is 1. That means work is equal to force into distance, and this will become a positive value. What are the different examples where force and displacement are in the same direction? The example will be a free fall of a body of mass, right? Okay, suppose there is a ball is falling, okay, there is a free fall of this body, and let's say this is the base, right? And this is position A, this is position B, and the mass of this body is M, therefore, and this height is, let's say, H, and this is the direction of motion or displacement. Direction of motion, or we can say displacement. Okay, now here we can say in free fall of a body of mass, let's say M, under gravity, okay, so there must be some gravitational force applied on this body through a height h, okay, so height is h here, from A to B, the force of gravity, right, which is F, force of gravity, let me write this, force of gravity is in the same direction of displacement. Displacement here is what? displacement here is H, that is S, and the work done by the force of gravity W is equal to what? Force into displacement, that is force into S, right? And force is what? Force is equal to mass into gravity. So we can say force here is mg, and S, if in this case we can say h is the height because it's falling from top, right? So we can say work is equal to mass into gravity into height, right? In case of a free fall of a body of mass, m under gravity through height h, right? So this is the one of the example. Another example will be, let's say a pulley does work on a load when he raises it up against the force of gravity. So another example, I'm just writing a pulley example where a pulley lifts certain load on his head, right? Now both the force exerted by pulley, that is one is mg and another one is displacement, because he is moving, right? He is not just putting the force or putting the weight on his head, he is moving as well, right? So the work done by the pulley will be what? Work into mass into gravity into distance or displacement, what he is covering, right? So that's example of pulley. And the third one is, if a body resolved in a circular path from an axis, let's say this body is resolving, if a body revolving in a circular path under the influence of a force, let's say this is a force, right? On completing of a one round, what happened? The displacement is zero because this body is actually on the same place where it started, right? Displacement is zero here. That means what? Force is there. Suppose this is force, but displacement means S is zero. So work done will be what? F into zero, and that will become work is equal to zero, right? So in circular path, one complete round, the work will be zero. So that is case number one. So friends, so far we have seen in case number one where displacement is in the direction of force, right? So here we have covered in case number one where displacement is in the direction of force, that's why your theta is 0 degree. Now in another case, we are going to see if the displacement is normal to the direction, means perpendicular to the direction of force, that is here theta is equal to 90 degrees, then we can say cos 90 degree is equal to zero. That means work done is zero, right? You understood this? Because work is equal to F cos theta into S, and here if is zero, then of course zero into anything will be zero, right? Now what are the examples here to understand this case? Let's say we have a pulley. Friends, I am not good in drawing, so let me just try to put as my best drawing here. So let's say this is a pulley, okay? Now this is a bag, and this is the exactly the normal to the road or horizontal ground, right? So these are two legs. Okay, I'm just putting, and this is the exactly 90 degree, you can say. Now here you can see, when a coolie walk on a horizontal ground, suppose this is horizontal ground, while carrying a load on his head, no work is done against the force of gravity. If I'm talking about force of gravity, no work is done. Why? Because displacement of load, even if this load move from here to here, but the angle again is 90 degree. Okay, suppose this load is at A, but this pulley move from here to here, this load is here at location B, but even then the angle which is making against horizontal ground is 90 degree. That's why no work is done against a force of gravity, right? I'm explaining again this thing, because the displacement of load from here to here is normal to the direction of force. Direction of force is where? Is the gravity from upper to downward, which is vertically downward, right? But here you need to make a note that pulley does work. There is certain work is done by the pulley, and let me just write here, the pulley does work. Why? Because there was a force, there was a displacement, work against the force of friction. When he moves with the load, right? So that's example number one. Now another example is, let's say this is example number two, where when a body moves in a circular path in a horizontal plane, let's say this is a ground. Okay, now this circular body, let's say this is moving, then in that case is there will be a no work is done. Why? I am saying, if there is a circular path in which a body is moving in a horizontal plane, then I am saying there will be a no work is done. Why I am saying this? The reason being, I am saying this, if you remember, what is the formula of work? Is F cos theta into S, where S is displacement, right? Now here you can see, since the centripetal force on the body at any instance, let's say this is the centripetal force, is always toward the center of circular path. Wherever you try to see, the centripetal force is always towards the center of this circular path. That is one. Another thing is displacement. Let's say if you are talking any point, let's say this one, right? Say okay, so displacement at that instance is along the tangent of the circular path. Means if you try to calculate the displacement of this point along the tangent, this angle will be what? Always 90 degrees. Either if you try to find it out here, 90 degrees. Either if you try to find it here, it's always same here and also same here. Anyway, this is a horizontal ground, but again it's a 90 degrees, right? So this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree. So what does it mean? Why I'm saying this 90 degree? What's the problem when I'm saying 90 degrees? The problem is, if you put the value of cos theta as cos 90 into displacement, cos 90 is what? 0. That is force into 0 into displacement. This makes what? This means work is 0. Alright, so what we have understood here, that no work is done in case a body moves in a circular path in a horizontal plane. Let me just write it here. No work is done in case of body moves in a circular path. Okay, next topic is, so based on the condition we have studied so far, what we can say? We can say two things here. Let me write first conditions for the work done by a force to be zero. What are those conditions? First condition, do you remember when we said in case of no displacement? Remember my previous example? If not, go back to this video and check. Right, that means when there is no displacement, right, whatever force you are applying on the body, let's say this is a body you are applying force, but displacement is 0, that means work is equal to force into displacement, and this is 0, then work will be 0. This is what I have explained in detail in my same video. You just need to go back if you missed. Second thing, what I have explained few moments back, that when the displacement, when the displacement is normal, means perpendicular, NORMAL, okay, normal to what? To the direction of force. Remember when I have explained this? Friends, just now I explained this, right? That's the reason. Because here, that is when theta is equal to 90 degrees, then cos theta is equal to 0, and that's why work is 0, right? So in these two conditions, work is 0, right? So in another word, we can say work done by a force is 0. This could be your one of the question in your exam, or this kind of a logic is going to be implemented in certain question for sure. Now I'm going to explain you the third case. So friends, so far what we have covered? What are the cases we have covered? The first case where the displacement is in the direction of force, that is where work is positive. Okay, this is what I have explained in case 1, right? Second case, I have explained where your work is 0. That means if the displacement is normal to the direction, this and this I have just explained. Now, in third case, I am going to explain in case of negative, right? I am talking about work as in a negative. So, we have explained positive, we have explained 0, and now in case 3, we are going to see in what cases work will be the negative value. So, in this case, if the displacement, let me write first, if the displacement is in a direction, friends, this is very important line, just try to understand each and every word here, just keep focus, right? I need a more focus here in this line. So here is saying if the displacement is in the direction opposite to whom? To the force. Means what? Means theta. So far we have understood 0, then 90, but here is 180 degree. Then what does it mean? This means cos theta is equal to cos 180 degree is equal to minus 1. Is that mean work is equal to minus force into displacement? Right? Because here in this case the direction of displacement is opposite to the force. That means here we can say work done is negative. Now when this kind of condition qualify, when this happen, that work done itself is negative. Friend, this is usually the case when the force opposing the motion or try to stop a moving body, right? That means force opposes the motion or at least it tries to stop a moving body. In that case, work done will be negative. Let me give you some example. First and very easy example to understand is if you throw a ball upward. Okay, so let's say this is a ball you throw upward, suppose up to here, right? Let's say this is what? This is direction. Friends, my drawing is actually very bad. This is what? This is direction of motion or displacement. Okay, why? Suppose this is A position. Now, okay, this is a horizontal plane and this is, let's say, B position, right? And this is height h. Now what happened here? The force, of course, the gravitational force, what we called m into g, mass into gravity, is in opposite direction, right? So F is equal to mg means direction of motion and the force both are in opposite direction. What I explained in case 3. If the displacement is in the direction opposite to the force, that is, this is a very good case of 180 degree, right? So in this case, what happened? When a ball of mass, let's say M, is thrown upward direction from A to B to a height H, the displacement H, let's say this is H, which is on upward direction, is opposite to the direction of force of gravity mg, and that too in downward direction. So the work done by a force of gravity mg is in displacement of H will be negative mgh, right? That is negative. That is a very classic example to understand the case where work done is negative. Similarly, when a body moves on a surface, okay, let's say there is another body. This is example 2. Okay, now this body is moving, for example. Now some force is applied here, but there is some friction. Okay, there is some friction. The force of friction between the body and the surface, this area, is in opposite direction to the motion of the body. Force try to move this body this way, this side, on the right hand side, but this friction is trying to stop. This is what I have just written. Therefore, work done by a force of friction is negative. So work done by force of friction is negative, right? So this is another example. Now here we need to note few things. This is just for your note purpose, just for your understanding. So far, what we have understood that all the force are constant, right? But let's say force is variable. Let's say force is variable. What does it mean? That at some moment of time, there was force of, let's say, 2 Newton. So after some time, the force could be 1 Newton, force could be 4 Newton, anything, right? But the force is varying, is not constant. That's the point here. So if the force is variable, that is, force varies during the displacement, what I have just understood, the work done is determined. Let me draw a diagram for you. So let's say this is a diagram I'm trying to explain what happens when force vary. This is force F, this is my y-axis, this is my x-axis. Let's say this is point A where force is this, and this is my displacement. S, right? And this is the some gray area where actually displacement happened. Now let me explain you this graph. So the force is taken on y-axis and the displacement is on x-axis. Now the area enclosed by this sketch and the displacement axis, means this one, gives the work done. What does it mean? It means the force is directly proportional to the displacement. What does it mean? If you apply certain force, let's say here F1, the displacement will be, let's say, S1. If you increase the force to F2, then accordingly displacement also move to S2. And if you move to, let's say, F3, then displacement also move to S3. That means as soon as you increase the force, displacement also increases. So the work done, let me find out the work done then. So the work done by the force, let's say F1, F2, F3 or F, in the displacement S1, S2 or S, is equal to the triangle OAB, whatever be in this grayish area, right? Let's say this is our B and this is the half of the area what is supposed to be, right? So this will become half of force into displacement, right? So this is another understanding formula for your reference. That's case number one. Now this method is applicable in all situations. For example, if the force is constant, what does it mean? This means it does not change with the displacement. Force always be the same. Means if I draw the same graph again, this is X, this is Y, this is O. So the force whatever I am applying here is the same along with the displacement. This X bar is displacement, this is displacement S. And if even, okay, so this is force, y-axis is force, F, any place force is always the same, right? So that means what? Here the force is same, this is F, here again force is F, here again force is F. So in that case the graph will look like this, right? Let's say this is B, this is A, this is C. So in that case the area of rectangle, here the area was triangle but here the area is rectangle, which is, let me write here, area of rectangle, what? OABC, OAB and C is equal to what? Force into displacement, right? Enclosed between that straight line, this one, and x-axis will be equal to the work done. Means that will be the same work done what you are applying at different moment, right? From here, 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 but the work done will be same because displacement is same in that case, right? So this is the example of work done by a constant force and this is example of work done by a variable force. Okay, so this is about force when it's variable and force when is constant. Now next topic is coming as work done by the force of gravity, right? So far we are considering some force which is applied by some human or some machine, but now here we are talking about the work done by the force of gravity. Let me write the heading first. So heading is saying work done by the force of gravity, that is work is equal to mass into gravity into height. Now let's say there is a body, this one, and it is having a mass m, is moved downward towards a vertical height either through inclined plane, okay, let's say there is a plane, or let's say hill slope or any stairs. So here they are saying the force of gravity, right? In this case, force of gravity on this body is F is equal to mg, and that is acting vertically downward. Okay, that's one. And the vertical displacement in the direction of force means from here to here, let's say this is distance is s, then that is actually your displacement, what we are considering here it as in a h. Therefore work is equal to force into displacement, and that is equal to mgh, right? Thus on that basis we can conclude that the work done, let me write, work done by the force of gravity is same whether the body comes down from a certain height, using the stairs, or slope, or even a lift, right? So even if body is moving by elevator, but the work done by the force of gravity will be the same in all cases. Similarly, if a body of, let's say, mass m goes upward through a vertical height of, let's say, h, either directly or through stairs, or directly, that means you can throw a what, or through any slope also, let's say you are moving from here to here in a slope, or either the lift, the work done is equal to what, positive or negative? Pause the video and just think. Work done will be negative mgh, right? Why this is negative? Just go back to this video and I have explained in detail why this is negative. Let me tell you quickly first. Because the displacement is in a direction opposite to the force, and here the theta is 180 degrees, right? Okay, so that's why work is equal to minus mgh, right? So this is all about work done by a force of gravity, right? Now the last topic of work is units of work. Units of work. So in SI unit, work is joule. And its abbreviation, or we denote this as a capital J. Now, since work is equal to what? Force into displacement, right? Therefore, 1 joule is what? 1 joule is equal to 1 force. Unit of force is what? Newton. So that is equal to 1 newton. And displacement is what? In meter, that is 1 meter. Therefore, we can say 1 joule of work is said to be done when a force of how many newton? 1 newton, right? Of 1 newton displace a body through a distance of how many meter? Through a distance of 1 meter in its own direction. Okay. Right? Now, if I'm talking about some bigger unit, so bigger unit of work is, kilojoule, kilojoule. We can represent this as in a kj. Okay. And there is a one more unit which is called as a megajoule, mega, joule. We can represent this as an mj. And there is a one more called a gigajoule, giga, joule. 1 kj is equal to 10 to the power 3 joule, or 1 mj is equal to 10 to the power 6 joule, and 1 gj is equal to 10 to the power 9. And if I'm talking about CGS unit, then the unit of work is erg, where 1 erg is equal to 1 dyne into 1 centimeter. Therefore, we can say 1 erg of work is said to be done when a force of 1 dyne, 1 dyne displaces a body through a distance. How much distance? Through a distance of 1 centimeter in its own direction. Right? Now, if I'm talking about some relationship between joule and erg, so let me write quickly here. Relationship, let me write in next line. Relationship between joule and erg. So 1 joule is equal to 1 newton into 1 meter, but 1 newton is what? 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne, dyne, and 1 meter is what? 10 to the power 2 centimeter. Therefore, 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne into 10 to the power 2 centimeter, and this is equal to 10 to the power 7 dyne into centimeter is equal to 10 to the power 7 erg. Therefore, 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 erg. As simple as that. Right? So, this is the relationship between joule and erg. 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 erg. Right? So, friend, this is all about topic work under chapter work power and energy.